Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the UWI Captain Horace Burrell Centre of Excellence. It's the 2019-2020 Women's JFF Women's Knockout Finals, and it's between Olympic Gardens and Neighbours and defending champions, Waterhouse Football Club. So once again, it's the finals of the 2019, number 12, Money Price, number 6, Carol White, number 18, Christiana Robinson, number 7, Tatiana Pollard, number 8, Tashana Malcolm, number 23, Kavina Reed, and number 4, Roxy Summer. That's the starting lineup for the Alicia James, Adrian Kitson coach team, which is managed by Michael Peel. Once again, starting lineup, Roxy Summer, number 4, Kavina Reed, number 23, Tashana Malcolm, number 8, Tatiana Pola, number 7, Christiana Robinson, number 18, Carol White, number 6, Money Price, number 12, Stephanie Morgan, number 3, Shanice Evans, number 19, Renee Scott, number 9, and Tashelle Welcome, number 1, the goalkeeper.
Hello and welcome to the 2020 JFF Knockout Women's Final, and it's Olympic Gardens versus Waterhouse in this final. Two neighboring communities, so it's a derby match. Very interesting one here, and rivalry has been building over the season because Olympic Gardens is actually the only team to have beaten Waterhouse this season. Waterhouse has gotten their revenge, though, because they were the team to knock Olympic Gardens out of the semi-finals. So, another rematch here in the final of the knockout competition promises to be a very enthralling competition. We have the Vice President of the Jamaica Football Federation, Raymond Anderson, coming out to meet the teams now, followed by the General Secretary of the Jamaica Football Federation, Mr. Dalton Wint. Now Mr. Anderson is met by Waterhouse captain Tashika Small, and he meets the rest of the Waterhouse lineup. Waterhouse convincingly dispatching off Arnett Gardens by 17-1 in the semi-final on aggregate to get to this knockout final. They'll be hoping to bring that rich goal-scoring form into the final here against Olympic Gardens.
Ladies Ladies and gentlemen, please rise.
Now we'll have the playing of the national anthem.
Gentlemen, it's now
okay, so it's the final of the JFF Women's Knockout Competition here at the UAJFF Captain Horace Burrell Center of Excellence. Let's have a run through of the lineups for the two teams. First, we have Waterhouse. In goal, we have Tiana Schroeter. Rest of the lineup sees Carolina Williams, Navigail Abel, Tashika Small, the captain, Lacey Ann Murray, Latoya Duhaney, Chantel Bailey, the leading goal scorer in the competition, Davia Richards, number 20, Jessica Johnson, Chanel Buckley, and the lineup is completed by number 17, Dejanay Anderson. Now for the Olympic Gardens team, we have Tashelle Welcome, Renee Scott, Shanique Evans, Stephanie Morgan, Monique Price. One to watch out for in this game, the number 12 for Olympic Gardens, very talented player, has a wonderful strike from that left foot. And the rest of the lineup sees Carol White, Kishana Robinson, Tatiana Pollock, Tashana Malcolm, Kevina Reed, national representative, and Roxine Salmon. So the teams just about ready for this 3 p.m. kickoff here at the Captain Horace Burrell JFF Center of Excellence. It's lovely conditions for football. There's a cool wind blowing over the pitch here. Just about ready for kickoff now. It's the final of the JFF Women's Knockout Competition. I'll be a match commentator for the day, Lance White, and we are just about ready for kickoff now. It's a local derby, neighboring communities here in the final. Waterhouse, serial title winners over the past 2 years. Olympic Gardens in their first final. And no doubt this is an underdog story, but it's not over until it's over. That's why we play the games, and we're on the way now, with Waterhouse kicking from right to left in their full yellow strip. Olympic Gardens sporting their red tops and white bottoms will be kicking from left to right. And it's an early giveaway with Waterhouse trying to launch an immediate attack. A bit of a mix-up there, and Waterhouse earned themselves an early corner. Chances for them to try and put Olympic Gardens under some pressure early in the match here. Corner taken quickly by Davey Richards, and it swung in. Deflection, but it will go behind for another corner. Promising start here for Waterhouse. They have Olympic Gardens pinned down in the half. Early in this first half, another chance for him to swing this one in. Hopefully a better delivery this time, and it is a better delivery. It goes in, headed out by the Olympic Guards defense, but not cleared all the way. shapes the shoot. No foul, says the referee. Now it's a chance for Olympic Gardens to break. Trying to use the pace of Kevina Reed there, but it's a good interception by the captain, Tashika Small. Launches it forward for Davia Richards to chase, and she shows some good skill. Olympic Gardens just struggling to settle since the start of the match here. Kevina Reed just running that one out of play. So it's a throw into Waterhouse on the far side. Waterhouse seeming to have settled in position very early, and it's a first touch of the ball for Chantel Bailey. Not too convincing with her touch there, and position is turned back over. Olympic Gardens can't seem to really get a spell of position going. It's all a bit clumsy in the middle. Nice win that from Kevina Reed, and she sends her teammate on a run. She's making a run through the middle. Lovely run, but just a bit too much on the pass there for Kevina Reed, and it will go all the way through to goalkeeper Tiana Schrouter. It's Neville Gale able for Waterhouse, trying to dribble out from the back, and she's obliges the Olympic Gardens team and kicks it long. Both teams just having a bit of trouble settling early on. Can't really get much passing going. Chantel Bailey, closely attended to by four Olympic Gardens players. Loses all the ball. Now Olympic Gardens will try to break. Olympic Gardens pressing high up. It's Olympic Gardens. This one will break. Crucial intervention that from the Waterhouse defense with Kevina Reed lurking. Very dangerous player out on that left wing for Olympic Gardens. She'll definitely be looking to cut in on her stronger right foot and get a shot off anytime she's in possession. But no, it's Waterhouse. Never Gale able spreading this one out for Jessica Johnson, who's tackled up by the Olympic Gardens defense. It's a throw in to Waterhouse. There's a player down for Olympic Gardens, who will need some attention from the medical staff. Player down for Olympic Gardens is Tashana Malcolm. She took a knock there in the challenge, going in for possession, battling with Waterhouse players. Seems to just be an impact injury though. Hopefully she will be able to walk this one off. So she's hobbling off. You have to keep an eye on that one to see if Malcolm will be able to continue. So for the time being, Olympic Gardens will continue with 10 players. And they have to defend this Waterhouse attack. They do so well. It's Kevina Reed, no one on this right-hand side. It's a good-looking ball down the channel. Abel can't keep that one in. Olympic Gardens trying to appeal for a handball, but referee says nothing doing. And now Olympic Gardens has to defend because Waterhouse is breaking. Well defended there. Monique Price looking for the runoff. Kevina Reed just now, but it's overhit. Waterhouse seemed very composed in possession. It's a team that likes to pass the ball around, scores a lot of goals. Price's pass is intercepted there, but she's on the ball again. Still Price. It's a wild tackle. And it's a free kick to Olympic Gardens over on that far side. Mm-hmm. Olympic Gardens can push players forward now for this set piece opportunity, and it is Kevina Reed standing over this one. She swings it in. It's a good looking ball cleared by Abel, but still some more work to be done here. And now the counter attack is on with Buckley in possession. Switched over to this far side. Oh, crucial intervention, but it breaks through for Chantel Bailey, who is running through on goal. She has Jessica Johnson, but she will go alone. Bailey with the shot, and she drags it just wide. That was a chance for Waterhouse. Brilliant chance. You know, back Chantel Bailey to finish that one there. She's been in immaculate goal scoring form recently. Just drags that one wide though. Probably had more time than she realized to set herself to get the shot off properly. Chance goes begging for Waterhouse. Olympic Gardens gets let off the hook, and now they can try and move forward. It's Price. Nice touch from Price. Good composure to find her teammate, but a missed control. And now Waterhouse looking to exploit that one, but good covering from Olympic Gardens. Both teams just having a bit of trouble trying to settle the ball in the middle of the field. It's a bit untidy. A lot of turnovers. Price looking, she has the run off Kevina Reed, and that's a wonderful pass. Kevina Reed threw on goal, and she does get a shot off, and it goes just wide. Goalkeeper Shorter advanced and got in a mix up with her defender. It was Dejanay Anderson who got in the way of Shorter, and Kevina Reed had the goal all to herself, but she couldn't find the target. That one goes begging. That one goes begging for Olympic Gardens. A brilliant chance. Both teams could have been on the score sheet early in this first half, but it's still nil all here. Waterhouse has a bit of defending to do now. Good strength shown on the ball there from Waterhouse player. It's Latoya Duhaney takes the free kick, and it's intercepted by Olympic Gardens. Now they look to break. Olympic Gardens always looking for the run of Kevina Reed. She has blistering pace down that left-hand side, but wasn't on the same wavelength as the pass just now, so that one goes out for a throw into Waterhouse, who will look to build from the back again. It's Tashika Small coming forward with this one. Waterhouse gaining ground as they have another throw-in further up the pitch this time, and it's Davia Richards on the ball. It's back to Tashika Small, who was slotted into that central defensive role very well for Waterhouse. Switched pass looking for Jessica Johnson, but it's just behind her, and it will go out for a throw-in to Olympic Gardens. As I mentioned earlier, Olympic Gardens qualifying for their first final here, looking to make a bit more history, you know, by lifting the title here today in the knockout final. But it'll be a strong ask of them, you know, being up against this brilliant Waterhouse team, who have really dominated women's football in Jamaica over the last couple of years. Waterhouse going for another treble, and this is a promising position for Olympic Gardens. It's Kevina Reed on a stronger right foot, but it's a brilliant tackle from Tashika Small. Now it's Price back to Reed. Reed has the shot from the left foot, but it's a daisy cutter, easily dealt with by goalkeeper Tiana Schroeter. The number six for Olympic Gardens, Carol White, linking up very nicely with Monique Price and Kevina Reed up top for Olympic Gardens so far. A bit of a scare there for Olympic Gardens at the back, trying to play their way out of the back, but Waterhouse not making it easy for them, pressing them very high up the field. That one cleared by Small. Buckley very Again, Olympic Gardens looking for the run of Kevina Reed. On that occasion, it was Pollock. Nice run from Davia Richards, steaming down that right-hand side. Nice cutback. The cross comes in, but it's weak and it's easily dealt with. Olympic Gardens should clear this one. White coming back on side to collect that one. She's been linking up very nicely with the midfield. Now it's with Pollock. Price. Looking out wide, always looking for Kevina Reed. Now she does go and try to find her with the pass, but it's overhit. Olympic Gardens so far might be a bit guilty of trying to force the play a bit too much in the direction of Kevina Reed. They need to spread it a bit more. Sometimes better options are on when they try to find Kevina Reed and it doesn't work out. Will probably be well served later in the match to try and utilize Pollock over on the right wing more often. But for now, they have a free kick to defend, and it's Small who will swing this one in. It's under hit and easily dealt with at the near by the first man, and it's Monique Price now. Very strong player, strong dribbler. Now it's with Kevina Reed. Ball does go out of play, but the referee calls it back for a free kick for Olympic Gardens. Kevina Reed, a judge to have been fouled. And it will be Reed who takes this one. Looking to find the head of White, but it's cleared. Ball loose in the middle of the field, and it's Dehaney who finds Nabil. Able to put under pressure there by Pollock. Waterhouse just about managed to keep possession. Now it's spread out wide to Jessica Johnson. Buckley making a nice run. And it's Roxine Salmon who comes across with a very strong challenge to clear the ball. The Olympic Gardens captain, very vocal in the back line, demanding her teammates, well closed down by White. Able trying to switch this one out wide for Davia Richards. Tackles flying in. Falls to Richards. She finds Chantel Bailey. Still Chantel Bailey. Olympic Gardens players appealing for a free kick. That's a lovely pass in behind the defense. Looking for Jessica Johnson. Keeper doesn't hold it. Eventually does manage to get both gloves on it. But Jessica Johnson making it very difficult for the goalkeeper. Poor clearance and it falls to Waterhouse. Jessica Johnson making herself a menace to the Olympic Gardens back line. She does win back position. Karuna Williams trying to swing that one in, but easily dealt with. And a nice move there from Monique Price. But the pass looking for White is easily intercepted. All right, it's Abel driving forward. Nice pass. Davy Richards swings in the cross looking for Jessica Johnson at the far post. Still Johnson. Johnson over dribbles that one. So it's a goal kick to Olympic Gardens. Johnson appealing for the corner kick, but there was no touch. Just overran that one on that occasion. Olympic Gardens again trying to play out from the back, and it played himself into trouble and playing themselves into all type of trouble here, Olympic Gardens, and they give the ball away again. So it's a throw-in deep into the Olympic Gardens half for Waterhouse. Buckley wins the header. Chantel Bailey with a nice move. Still Chantel Bailey. First, Dave Archer's at the back post. Oh. How hasn't that one gone in? Davy Richards seems certain to score just now after some lovely work in the box by Chantel Bailey, but the Olympic Gardens defense just about manages to survive that attack with the goalkeeper. Tashelle Welcome managing to get both gloves on that one. Scary moment there for Olympic Gardens. Again, causing themselves all types of trouble, trying to play themselves out of the back, but Waterhouse pressing very high up the field and putting them under a lot of pressure. It's Olympic Gardens in possession now, trying to create an attack. It's been all Waterhouse over the last 10 minutes or so. Overhit, trying to find Monique Price. Dehaney's down, but the referee signals to play advantage. Not much of an advantage here with Olympic Gardens winning back possession. Ball does go out of play now. Dehaney's still down. Dehaney's still down, so the referee will attend to her now. And she will get some attention. Still nil all here in the JFF Women's Knockout Competition Final. With about 20 minutes gone, Waterhouse versus Olympic Gardens, two neighboring communities. It's a derby match, very hotly contested so far. These two teams are no strangers. They have met quite a number of times. Quite a number of times down the line in the season so far. With Waterhouse managing to get the better of Olympic Gardens more often than not. But Olympic Gardens is actually the only team to have beaten Waterhouse this season early in the league.
Waterhouse Olympic Gardens
Nice 1-2 there, looking for the run of Pollock. Flag goes up on this near side though. Referee hasn't seen it as yet. Referee signaling for a throw-in, but the assistant still has her flag up. Referee sees it now, and it will be an offside call. Abel looking for Davia Richards, well intercepted. Now Olympic Gardens can try to move forward. Aimless pass forward, intercepted by Chantel Bailey. Bailey finds the boot of Johnson. Strong tackle, but it does break. Nice move from Buckley. Buckley running through, still Buckley trying to cross the ball for Johnson, who was waiting in the middle, but it's intercepted. Now Kevina Reed has the grass in front of her to run into. Well tackled up by Nevergale Abel. Kevin Reed had the beating of Abel for pace just now, but Abel with a very intelligent run to come across and cover her, and the tackle sees the deflection go off her, and it was a goal kick. Brilliant piece of defending there from Abel. Waterhouse now back in possession. Dehaney over dribbling it on that occasion just now, and it will be a throw in to Waterhouse, who can build from the back again. Johnson finds Buckley. Buckley with a very ambitious ball looking for Chantel Bailey, and it's cut out only to Johnson, who comes inside closely watched by the Olympic Guards defense, who does win possession. Now it's back at the feet of Monique Price. Kevin Reed making a wonderful run down this right hand side, but that one had a bit too much on it. Waterhouse wasting no time in getting the ball back into play. That one thumped downfield by Abel, and Chantel Bailey challenges for it and wins it. She has the run of Jessica Johnson to her left, but she chooses the one of Chanel Buckley. Buckley goes out wide to Davia Richards, who winds up a shot, and it's over the crossbar. Couldn't keep that one down. It was a good chance for Davia Richards. Waterhouse making that possession count now, creating more opportunities. Just edging Olympic Gardens for more opportunities created in this first half. They've had more possession and more shots. Again, they're back in. Brilliant pass. It's Davia Richards who goes down on the challenge, and it's a penalty. Referee points to the spot. Protest from the Olympic Gardens players, but the referee has no doubt, and it's a yellow card. No doubt in the mind of the referee as he brandishes the yellow card and points to the penalty spot. It's a chance for Waterhouse to go up in this final. It all started from a brilliant pass from Jessica Johnson, who found Davia Richards, completely turned the defender inside out and won the penalty kick. And it will be Davia Richards who will take this penalty kick. With just about 25 minutes gone in this first half, Waterhouse has a brilliant chance to go ahead. Davia Richards steps up. She makes no mistake from the penalty spot, and it's Waterhouse who go 1-0 up in this final. Davia Richards. That one wasn't right in the corner. Keeper got close to it, gets the right direction, but couldn't get a hand on it. Keeper might be a bit disappointed she didn't get a hand to that because it wasn't right in the corner, but nevertheless, a good penalty kick from Waterhouse. This is striker Davia Richards, and that goal coming just before the first water break here in the first half. As the referee points the players towards the bench to take in some fluids. So at the first water break here, at about the 25-minute mark, it's Waterhouse leading by a goal to nil, courtesy of a goal from Dave Richards from the penalty spot.
Issued to number 19, Kenneth Evans, in the 22nd minute. So, 22nd minute caution to Olympic Gardens number 19, Kenneth Evans. The goal also came in the 22nd minute. Number 20, Davia Richards from the penalty spot.
So, confirmation there. It was Kenneth Evans, the number 19 for Olympic Gardens, who received that yellow card just now, giving away the penalty. And the goal coming in the 22nd minute by Davia Richards. The players are back out on the field now after that water break. And Olympic Gardens has some work to do, trailing by a goal to nil. Waterhouse getting the breakthrough goal from penalty spot with Davia Richards converting. This will now test the mental strength of this Olympic Gardens team going down. We know they are very strong mentally because they had to come from behind in the semi-finals after they lost the first leg. Chantel Bailey there trying to find the run of Davia Richards. But Olympic Gardens are real mentality monsters. They came from 3-2. They were trailing by 3-2 in the first leg of the semifinals to Cavalier to come back and beat them by 4-1 in the second leg to advance to the final. So they're no strangers to being behind. Dangerous back pass there. Pollock intercepts. Oh, brilliant challenge, but she should have finished that one. She did all the hard work and couldn't find the back of the net. Couldn't get the shot off. Brilliant challenge from Tashika Small, though, after a risky back pass was intercepted. And Small stays down. That was a very risky back pass from the Waterhouse defense and almost paid the ultimate price. Tashika Small may have yet paid the ultimate price after picking up a knock. Hopefully she'll be able to continue. Meanwhile, I can see on this near touchline where Olympic Gardens is preparing a substitution. It's Ashley Sawyers. Ashley Sawyers will be coming into the match. Sheeler plays number 11 for the Olympic Gardens team. Number 8, rather, Tashana Malcolm. So Sawyers comes in for Malcolm. And it's Olympic Gardens in possession. Lose our possession to Waterhouse. It's a free kick to Waterhouse. Duhaney winning the free kick there. Protecting the ball very well. Strong tackle there. Olympic Gardens just trying to spread the ball around. That's a bad attempt there, but it's intercepted by Abel, who has been brilliant so far in this game. Oh! That will be a yellow card. Hand right across the face of Jessica Johnson. Second yellow card of the match this for Olympic Gardens, and it goes to the number 9, Renee Scott. For serious foul play. Well, not so serious. If it was so serious, you would have gotten a red card, but still very dangerous. And it's a free kick to Waterhouse. It'll be from a central position. Standing over this one is number 12, Lacey Ann Murray. Don't think she'll go directly for goal from this distance. Well, I could be wrong. She seems to be shaping up to have a shot. Let's see what will come of this one. Murray. Not a bad hit. Straight down the middle and easy enough for the goalkeeper. Now she can break.
Second caution of the contest.
And it's a first touch of the ball for Sawyers.
Olympic Gardens number 9.
Almost given away, but he does find Kevina Reid. Reid strongly tackled up by number 23, Williams. And now Waterhouse trying to break. It's cleared by the captain. Haney looking to find the runoff, Davia Richards. Richards trying to get him in behind, but it's well shielded up, and the defender does well to win the free kick. Good bit of defending on that occasion from Shanique Evans. Buckley. Nice move. Still Buckley. Oh, it's a late challenge. And she's on a yellow card. That's a second yellow and she's off. A bit of madness there. from Renee Scott. That was crazy. Her team is down by one goal. It's a final. It's in the first half. Team has every chance of getting back into the game. She completely loses her head and picks up a second yellow card in the space of 5 minutes. Completely losing it just now, and her team is in a serious predicament. This task just got a whole lot harder for Olympic Gardens. If they're going to win their first championship, they're going to have to do it with 10 players.
Ejected in the 31st minute for Olympic Gardens.
Renee Scott picking up a second yellow card. Olympic Gardens has it all to do now. Quickly taking free kick. Abel with a shot, and this one's skewed just wide. Price looking for the run. Another interception by Nevergale Abel. Now it's Buckley. Finds Johnson. Johnson is quickly closed down. Buckley again. Looking for Chantel Bailey, but it's intercepted. You can see Waterhouse just upping it a notch now. They know that Olympic Gardens is there for the taking. Lacey and Murray looking for the run off Davia Richards. Just a bit too much on that one, and it will go through to Welcome in goal. Welcome goes long. Only White, the only target up there, and she's surrounded by four Waterhouse players all the time. So the inevitable is the outcome. And now it's Buckley coming forward again. Still Buckley driving at goal. She has the shot, and it's not a bad effort. Not a bad effort from Buckley just now. Buckley, the youngest player in this Waterhouse team, just about 15 years old, a national representative, and a very talented player. Waterhouse just upping the tempo a bit. Olympic Gardens gives possession straight back, but nice tackle in the middle from Monique Price. Still Price. Very strong dribbler on the ball. Looking for that killer pass, and it's back with Price. Still Price driving. It's like she has the ball stringed to her boot. They can't get it off her. Brilliant bit of play from Monique Price, but it seems as if she's trying to do it all on her own. She needs some help from her teammates now. Driving run from Duhaney. It's back with Duhaney. Duhaney holding off the defenders, and she plays it back. It's Anderson. Intercepted by Sawyers. Sawyers needs to hurry up and get rid of this one. She does so. That's a handball by Lacey and Murray. It's taken quickly, but Monique Price wasn't looking. Waterhouse win back possession. Now it's Tashika Small looking for the 1-2 with Davia Richards. Can she get there? Showing good pace, but she does get there. But a good recovery from the defender, and it will be a goal kick. Waterhouse really upping the tempo in the last 5 minutes or so following that red card. They sense blood, and they're trying to put this one to bed early in this first half. That one goes out of play. A lot of protest from the fans over on that far side. They're saying that didn't go out of play, but the assistant referee rose the flag, and it will be a throw-in. Throw-in already taken, so it's Waterhouse coming forward now. That one swung across by Duhaney. Nice interception from Sawyers out of position now. Johnson making the run. Sawyers tracking back to make the tackle yet again. Sawyers has been very solid since coming on. Oh. Dehaney with a shot. It's blocked. Olympic guards just can't seem to get out. Here come Waterhouse again. Lacey and Murray plays it through to Chantel Bailey. Here's Bailey. The cutback for Lacey and Murray. Murray goes to ground but gets back up. Davier Richards back with Chantel Bailey. Olympic Gardens has numbers back. Challenge going in there. Another strong challenge, and it will be a throw-in to Olympic Gardens. Olympic Gardens surviving that attack. Getting numbers back. Snuffing it out. Now it's White. Oh, couldn't find the pass to set away Kevina Reed, who has caught an isolated figure since the... Oh, nice 1-2. It's Buckley in on goal. Still Buckley trying to play in Chantel. It does fall to Bailey. Bailey with a shot, and it's blocked. Owen stays in. The Olympic Gardens defense appealing for an offside call from the assistant referee, but it wasn't coming. Another pass intercepted by Waterhouse. Olympic Gardens having a lot of difficulty getting out of their own half, which is understandable. They are a player down. Sawyers completes the clearance. Now Kevina Reed trying to keep this one in. Kevina Reed trying her utmost to keep the one in, but it ran out of play. There's another player down. It's another player down for Olympic Gardens inside their own penalty area.
39 minutes. And it's Waterhouse that leads the contest by one.
There's a player down. There's a player down in the Olympic Gardens penalty area.
Converted by number 20, Davier Richards. Waterhouse 1, Olympic Gardens nil.
Player down seems to be number 3, Stephanie Morgan. Play resumes with a throw into Waterhouse. Buckley, with space to run into, finds Bailey. Davy Richards making a darting run, and Chantel Bailey finds a pass. Davy Richards threw on goal. She takes a shot, and it's off the post. Another brilliant chance for Waterhouse to double their lead. Davy Richards should have at least found the target there, and if she found the target, I would have certainly doubled Waterhouse's lead. A brilliant chance goes begging for Waterhouse. Olympic Gardens just about surviving and keeping the deficit at 1-0. Header won by Williams. Free kick to Olympic Gardens, a chance for them to get some players further up the field now. They've been stuck in their own half since that red card to Renee Scott. This one will be taken by Sawyers. Olympic Gardens pushing players up the field. Nice control from Monique Price. Still Monique Price. Closely attended to. Looking for, oh. There was potential there. But Pollock just straight offside. And now Waterhouse can look to break. Wonderful pass to find Jessica Johnson. Johnson cuts inside. Switches the play, trying to find the runoff. Chantel Bailey. Bailey will run onto this one. She has support from Davia Richards. She tries to go on her own, but she's crowded out.
Jessica, behind you.
Everyone's getting back to clean up. And that one is put into touch by number four, Roxine Salmon. So it's a throw into Waterhouse over on that far side. Waterhouse haven't managed to take advantage of this numerical advantage as yet. They have come close, creating solid work from Sawyers. He's been very effective in that right side of the defense since coming on. Reed. Clearance completed by Sawyers. Able. Able again finds Williams. Williams has, it's an aimless pass. Aimless pass forward by Williams, almost resulting in something with Chantel Bailey not giving up on that cause, but the keeper welcomes that one into her arms gratefully, sends it down the field, and it will run all the way through to Tiana Shorter from one end of the field to the other. So Neville Gale Abel has all the time and space in the world to wander forward. She opts to go back to Duhaney. Duhaney looking for the crossfield pass to Richards. She does find her, and Richards brought down, but referee says no free kick. This is a promising position. Monique Price looking for the run of Kevina Reed, but she did stop her run. Some of the Waterhouse players enjoying a lot of possession. Buckley trying the dummy there. It does come off. Back with Buckley. Strong challenge from Sawyers. That pass looking for Jessica Johnson. Just a bit too much on it, and it does go out of play. Sawyers again. She's been very impressive since coming on in this first half. Makes you wonder why she didn't start. That's a handball. Nothing there, says the referee. Duhaney has the run of Jessica Johnson. Crucial interception. Johnson was away down this left-hand side, and now Kevina Reed has room to run into. She has Abel to beat. She tries to push it past Abel. Brilliant recovery from Neville Gale Abel to get in the challenge, and it's a corner kick to Olympic Gardens. Corner swung in by Kevina Reed. At the near post, it beats Williams, but cleared away. Now Williams slices the clearance. Still work to do here from Waterhouse. And it will be another corner kick. The corner kick was not a very good one at the near post, but Waterhouse made a meal of clearing it, and now they'll have to defend again. Kevina Reed will swing this one in a better one this time. Heads go up, but it's over the head of the captain. Now Waterhouse has the potential to break. Counter-attack breaks down, though, with Pollock coming forward for Olympic Gardens again. It's Pollock for Olympic Gardens. Roxine Salmon finds White. White battling with Jessica Johnson. Good strength shown there from White. Nice touch from Sawyers. Tries to switch it. looking for Pollock, but it's just behind. Clearance completed by Dejanay Anderson. Nice touch that from Davia Richards. She has numbers in support. Chantel Bailey can't get past Salmon. Good interception there from Buckley to win back possession for her team. Oh, it's Dehaney on the ball. Oh, nice touch there from Chantel Bailey to find Buckley. Still Shield Buckley with a left foot. Oh! Brilliant interception. Still driven at the near post by Jessica Johnson, but it's well held by Welcome. And the whistle goes. It's the end of the first half. Very entertaining match here with Waterhouse leading by a goal to nil and Olympic Gardens playing with a player down following a red card to Renee Scott.
The defending champion, Waterhouse.
So Waterhouse going to the break with a one goal advantage. Could have been more, but credit to Olympic Gardens who have come out here with the right attitude going at Waterhouse. They had a setback midway through the first half when one of their players were sent off and also giving away the penalty kick, but still very much in this game.
Women's knockout final.
Let's see how they approach the second half, if they can get that equalizing goal. It's far from over here at the UEJFF Captain Horace Boyle Center of Excellence.
Lascelles Employees and Partners Cooperative Credit Union is one of the leading medium-sized credit unions in Jamaica. We have over 50 years of serving our members with savings, loans, and insurance products. High-yielding investments such as the Golden Harvest, Compounder, and Partner Plus. We have life insurance for the entire family, back-to-school loans and grants, Easter loans, Christmas loans, share loans, motor vehicle, and mortgage loans. Become a member today. We are waiting for you. Contact us at 876-923-5480 or 876-619-6667. Follow us on Facebook at Lascelles Credit Union, on Instagram at LEPCCU, and you can visit our website at www.lascellescreditunion.com.
We're ready for the start of the second half here with Waterhouse making three substitutions at the halftime interval. Number 18, Tiny Seaton. Number 19, Christina Salmon. And also Chevin Blair coming on for Waterhouse. So three substitutions as we get this second half underway here. Booted into the sky by Sawyers, and it's thumped back downfield. Oh, breaks to Chantel Bailey, and now it's with the substitute, Christina Salmon. Nice shot that from, oh, brilliant effort that from Chantel Bailey, just going wide. She strikes the ball so well with her right and left foot. It's very difficult to tell which foot she uses because she hits it so well with either foot, and that one was another gem from her right foot, just going wide off the right upright, almost catching the Olympic Gardens keeper out. Tashelle, welcome, counting her blessings on that occasion. Olympic Gardens survive another Waterhouse attack. It's with Jessica Johnson over on that far side. Now Williams. Chevin Blair making the run. Williams swings it in, but it's easily cut out. Salmon has been very lively since coming on, as well as Blair. Now it's Blair again. Nice move. And she plays it through for Jessica Johnson. She has Steiny Seaton in the box. Johnson finds Chantel Bailey. Her first touch is poor, and it allows Olympic Gardens to break. This one looking for... Oh, Kevina Reed gets there first. She has to watch the bounce of the ball. Still with Kevina Reed. Brilliant work from her to keep possession. But Waterhouse has managed to get players back. But there's the pace of Kevina Reed. Pace and the trickery. Can she get the cross in? She does. Does manage to get the cross in. Waterhouse players almost stopped playing on that occasion, thinking the ball had gone out of play, but referee says continue. No, it's with Chantel Bailey. Bailey plays it out wide to Anderson. Nice work from Seaton, but it's an aimless pass forward. Monique Price almost playing around into trouble just now. Still with Price. Such a strong dribbler. It's a strong tackle from the little player, Chevin Blair. Blair in the number 16. Oh, it's a late challenge on Lacey and Murray. Pollock had a chance to run around the defender. Nice move from Chantel Bailey. Plays the ball through for Jessica Johnson. She's through on goal. Has Sawyers. She gets past Sawyers. Not quite. Good defending from Sawyers. Still Sawyers. That strong defending. Manages to complete the clearance, but can only find Williams. Oh. Referee says that's a foul. Chantel Bailey getting there before the Olympic Gardens player, but she was adjudged to have been taken down. That contact must have been very, very slight because it seems as if she just lost her footing. But the referee says it's a foul. And it's a free kick to Olympic, to Waterhouse rather. Shot taken, and it's straight down the throat of the goalkeeper.
Three substitution for the Waterhouse team at the halftime break.
Welcome sends that one along.
Number 4, Nevergate Abel. Number 20, the goal scorer, Bavia Richards. And number 15, Shaheen.
Bailey trying to link up with Duhaney and does so well. Still Duhaney. Duhaney has the runoff. Jessica Johnson out wide. Johnson winds up the shot, and it's a brilliant effort. Just over the top from Jessica
and
Johnson.
Number 19, Akilia Johnson. So those are the substitution for Waterhouse 3 at the halftime break. Waterhouse 1. Olympic Gardens name.
Tashelle, welcome. Seem to have had that one covered. But it was very close from Jessica Johnson. Olympic Gardens gives back the possession to Waterhouse right away. Just a reminder that Olympic Gardens is playing with 10 players following the dismissal of Renee Scott in the first half. It's a foul by Chantel Bailey on Pollock. Sawyer is coming across to take this one. Yeah. Anderson put under pressure by Pollock. It's a wild swipe by Christina Salmon. It's a free kick for the foul on Stephanie Morgan. Sawyer is coming across to take this one again. Who has been very solid since her introduction in the first half. Switching this one, looking for the run of Kevina Reed. It's flicked on by Johnson, but only towards her goal. Waterhouse having a bit of trouble trying to clear this one. But it does eventually break for Jessica Johnson, who finds Dehaney. Dehaney has a run of seat, and she opts to go through the middle for Salmon, but that one is never going to trouble the Olympic Gardens defense, who can try and build from the back now. Goes all the way through to Monique Price, but she's miles offside, and that will be a free kick to Waterhouse. Olympic Gardens trailing by a goal to nil, and they're a player down, but they're still very much in this match. It only takes one moment for them to find the equalizer. And they're in possession now with Monique Price. Pollock, White to Price. Price bursting through, still Price. Now it's Kevina Reed. She beats Williams. Reed has the... Kevina Reed's cross is cut out. Now Waterhouse can break on the counter-attack. And it's Tiny Seaton with room to run into, but Morgan doing well to cover. Shepherding that one back to her goalkeeper. Welcome. Strong challenge on White. Referee says it's a fair challenge. There's a bit of frustration being shown by some of the Waterhouse players now, who can't seem to really keep possession of the ball. A lot of clumsy passes being played around, and they keep giving possession away. It's all a bit clumsy in the middle of the field now. Dehaney, with a nice run through. Oh, it breaks to Salmon, plays it through to Jessica Johnson. Johnson is onside. Still Johnson with a shot. And it's a save at the near post from Welcome. Should have been better served trying to open her body up and go for the far post or even look for a cross, but it's a shot on target for Waterhouse. Still Waterhouse unable to extend their lead. It's a risky pass from Pollock. And it's intercepted by Jessica Johnson. Pollock getting in the way of Johnson. Sayers shepherding her out wide, putting good pressure on, but I think she's gotten a bit carried away there and overdone it. So it's a free kick to Waterhouse, taken very quickly. Now it's with Chantel Bailey. Ops to cut back in on the left foot. Tries to play the 1-2 with Dehaney, but it's intercepted. Now it's White. Still White. Closely watched by Blair, but White finds a way to get through two players. Now goes back to her defense. It's Morgan. Olympic Gardens trying to come forward now, but that one goes out of play. Shanique Evans overhitting that one just now. That one breaks for Latoya Dehaney. She has the run off Jessica Johnson. She goes on the right foot and has the shot. That one bouncing right in front of the goalkeeper, giving her something to think about, but deals with it comfortably enough and boots it upfield. That will be a foul on Chevin Blair. This match being played at a very high intensity. Nice tempo to the game. Both teams pressing high and trying to create chances. Credit to Olympic Gardens, who haven't really let their heads drop since going a player down and still very much in this game. Can't help but think that if they were still playing with their full complement, they would have been even more dangerous. But this one breaks a Tiny Seaton. Tiny Seaton has pace. Her cross is cut out. Breaks on the top of the area for Monique Price, who finds Kevina Reed. And she one push past Williams and she's gone. Kevina Reed has pace to burn. She pushes it around. Oh!
Referee is having a look and he says nothing. Referee says it's a clean challenge. Tevina Reed with a brilliant run just now, getting past two players, and it seemed a certain foul, even a penalty maybe, but the referee said it's a throw-in. Referee says nothing doing, and the Olympic Gardens players and the bench is furious. The coach, Adrian Kitson, is going absolutely mental on the bench, and he can't believe it. If they have been complaining about the referees throughout this game, feeling that the decisions haven't gone their way, and that one will not do any help to the referee's case because that seemed a certain foul. Don't know how the referee missed that one, but again, it just goes to show that Olympic Gardens still very much a threat in this game. And Kevina Reed, a very, very good outlet to try and exploit this Waterhouse defense. She has pace to burn. She has a beating of every player in this Waterhouse defense for pace, so she can push it on. Now Kevina Reed with a bit of, that's a bit of retribution there, lashing out. She feels aggrieved that their foul was not gone in her direction, and she lashes out at the Waterhouse player and does receive a yellow card. She needs to keep her head though. Her team is still in this game. Doesn't want to make the same mistake that Renee Scott made in the first half, losing her head and getting a red card. But Olympic Gardens players need to keep their head in this match because they're still very much in the game. Even though the decisions aren't going their way, they still need to keep doing what they're doing and trust that chances will come their way. Waterhouse have to try and sort out
of Olympic Gardens
their defense though, because they have been caught sleeping on a few occasions. And now the referee consulting with the fourth official. Not sure what they're talking about, but I assume it has something to do with the decisions and the boisterous behavior of the Olympic Gardens bench, who have been absolutely livid. And the referee is reaching for his pocket yet again. I think he'll be brandishing a yellow card to referee with the red card. A member of the Olympic Gardens technical staff being ejected from the bench there after insulting the referee. No, that's no way to behave on the bench, no matter how much you feel the referee isn't giving the right calls, but it's all boiling over here. Still work to do on the pitch as Waterhouse come forward in attack again. Chantel Bailey still in possession. Nice work to get by two players. Shifts it onto her left foot. She has Jessica Johnson wide. It eventually breaks to Jessica Johnson. Now Blair. Blair has the shot. That one won't trouble welcoming goal. Chantel Bailey should have probably passed the ball there, but trying to do it all on her own. This match really heating up both on and off the field. Very intense match here. Ball played through for Kevina Reed. She sees the goalkeeper off her line and she tries the early shot, but it's dragged harmlessly wide. Probably would have been better served continuing her run into the box. But there's the danger of Kevina Reed on that right wing again. Olympic Gardens trying to really exploit that left-hand side of the defense because they see that Kevina Reed has the pace to burn. This is what local derbies are all about. Neighboring communities, very hotly contested match. Strong tackle there from Lacey and Murray and Monique Price. And the referee says it's a throw-in to Olympic Gardens. Monique Price turning inside, losing out to Anderson. Now Duhaney can break. She has three runs in front of her. Which one will she choose? Can't find any of them. But it does break to Jessica Johnson. Still Jessica Johnson. She has a bit of space here. Closed down quickly by Morgan. Now it's Duhaney. Duhaney is closely watched. Duhaney's pass is intercepted. Duhaney putting pressure on and gives away the ball. Duhaney stopped playing there. Just a bit of breakdown in communication between the Waterhouse players. Game being played at a very high tempo now, very high intensity. There's a ball onto Kevina Reed. Again, Kevina Reed wasn't making the run on that occasion. Again, Olympic Gardens just guilty of trying to force that ball into Kevina Reed when they would be better served playing other passes. No, Jessica Johnson. That's a decent looking ball in, but it's too close to the goalkeeper, and Welcome will claim that one with minimum fuss. Bit of frustration being showed by both teams now, with a lot of quarreling happening on the pitch. They need to regain their composure. There's still a lot of time to be played here in this final, and the game is still very much on, with Waterhouse leading by a goal to nil. That one is intercepted by Pollock. The run to Kevina Reed. The ball to Kevina Reed is on. Reed showing her pace. Tashika Small gets there and it goes just wide. She had to make the interception, but that one was a very scary clearance, almost hitting it into her own net. But thankfully, it goes just wide and it's a corner kick to Olympic Gardens. There's a very dangerous ball out to Kevina Reed again. She's been the main danger for them in this match. Her pace. Oh, it's a good cross in. Missed at the near post. Duhaney now. Duhaney running at Morgan. She has the beating of Morgan and she gets by her quite easily. It's Latoya Duhaney. Morgan tracking back. Morgan gets a toe to it. It's crucial. Oh, it, keeper spills it. Tiny Seaton with the chance and she blazes over from about 8 yards. And it's an empty goal and Tiny Seaton can't find the goal. That was a very good chance for them to put this one to bed, but Seaton can't hit the target. It's end-to-end stuff here in the final of the JFF Women's Knockout Competition. Will that chance come to haunt Waterhouse later in this final? Waterhouse having the chance to kill this one off, but the chance goes begging. Here comes Waterhouse again. Morgan with the clearance. Winds up for the shot. Lacey and Murray just showing some frustration. They're having a shot from way out. Not troubling. It's Kevina Reed again who has switched over to this left-hand side. Kevina Reed running that one out of play. Touched on by Salmon. Now it's Duhaney. Flicked on by Chantel Bailey and it's intercepted by Sawyers. Pollock. Monique Price loses out to Chevin Blair. Nice 1-2 to release Tiny Seaton who has pace. She cuts back though. Finds the runoff. Chantel Bailey who has a one-time shot. It's blocked by Sawyers. Does come back to Chantel Bailey who has the left-footed shot blocked by the number 4, the captain of Olympic Gardens. Roxine Salmon with the block on that occasion for Olympic Gardens. It's Chantel Bailey. Chantel Bailey with a shot. It's straight to the keeper. Kevina Reed comes inside on her favorite right foot. Still Kevina Reed. Nice run, and she's chopped down by Lacey Ann Murray. Brilliant work from Kevina Reed. She's been very good in this game, Kevina Reed. And no doubt she'll want to take this one. Picking the ball up over on this left-hand side. Dribbling inside, going past three players and being chopped down, winning her team up, free kick in a very promising position. Taking the game by the scruff of the neck, Kevina Reed. She's really stepping up in this final. And she stands over this one. She'll fancy this one. Good striker off the ball. The stance, and oh, she's feeling this one. Look at the stance. Almost Cristiano Ronaldo-esque. She's feeling this one. The run-up. Kevina Reed. Brilliant strike from Kevina Reed, and she finds the back of the net. What a brilliant strike from Kevina Reed to draw her team level. You knew it was going in from the moment she stood over it. You knew she was going to hit it, and you knew it was going to find the back of the net. Kevina Reed with a brilliant free kick to draw her team level in the final. I told you it would only take one chance. And a special player finds a special moment for a team who needed something special in this final to draw level.
Ball coming in the 68th minute. So Kevina Reed, number 23, scoring there.
Brilliant Olympic free Gardens kick.
In the 68th minute. Olympic Gardens 1. Waterhouse 1.
Just like in the first half, right after the goal, referee has blowed for a water break. So it's the water break in the second half here, and it's Olympic Gardens 1, courtesy of that brilliant free kick from Kevina Reed, and Waterhouse 1, courtesy of that first half penalty kick from Davia Richards. 1-1 in this final between Olympic Gardens and Waterhouse as we enter this water break. It's all to play for. All right, and we're back on the way after that water break with Olympic Gardens. Well, the referee has called it back, not happy with something. Now we're on the way. Olympic Gardens drawing level after that free kick from Kevina Reed. So now it's all to play for. Waterhouse need to respond now, but Olympic Gardens has the momentum. Now with Monique Price, Kevina Reed making that ever-present run, making herself an option. Pollock trying to find the run. I have accused Olympic Gardens of overly relying on Kevina Reed and trying to overplay the pass to her, but I mean, she has been exceptional in this match. Anytime the ball has come her way, she's really made something happen for her team, or tried to make something happen for her teammates. So you can see why they are really, really trying their best to play that ball every time. It's working for them, so why stop? It's a free kick, or a throw-in rather, over on that far side to Olympic Gardens. Just a reminder that Olympic Gardens is playing with 10 players and really pushing this Waterhouse team. That one sent along by Sawyers, headed by Tashika Small, and it's the pocket of Monique Price's pick just now. Just seems to have dipped a bit in the last 5 minutes or so. I don't know if it's fatigue setting in, but she needs to really dig in. Her team needs her now. One of the more exceptional players in this team. I think she's just straight offside there. Tashika Small getting back to cover for her team. All the Waterhouse players really digging in. A hand swipe there by Duhaney. And that would be a yellow card. The hand came up and went across the face of the player. The seams really unraveling for Waterhouse. No, I can't ever remember seeing them being this flustered in a match. They always seem so composed and in control. By now they would have been out of sight, but this Olympic Gardens team really pushing them. The underdogs have really turned up here today. And it's number 7 for Olympic Gardens, who has stayed down. Tatiana Pollock receiving treatment. Waterhouse players really showing their frustration now in an unfamiliar position here. Being really tested and pushed in this match. Players arguing with each other and showing all sorts of frustration. They need to regain their composure. They're still in a match. They're still very much in. Well, not really in control, but they're still in with a very good chance of winning this one. Still about 20 minutes to go. Kevina Reed, will she go from this distance? She did. It's a low one. It's easily intercepted. It's clear downfield. But as I was saying, Waterhouse need to quickly regain their composure. They're still in a good position to win the trophy here. They have about 20 minutes to go and they're a player up. Still very much in their hands to come back and win this one if they can regain their composure. But Olympic Gardens not making it easy for them at all. Misplaced pass that from Sawyers. That one played into touch and it will be a throw into Waterhouse. Tiny Seaton guilty of trying to overplay it there. She had a pass in front of her but she tried to dribble. Now it's Duhaney. Duhaney breaks the Pollock. Number 19, Akilah Johnson for Olympic Gardens coming into the game in the aftermath of that strong challenge there from Kevina Reed. Wins back the ball. Now Olympic Gardens trying to break, but it's well cut out and Chevin Blair is clipped. Free kick to Waterhouse taken quickly. Now it's Duhaney. Duhaney has been very much active in the middle of the park in this game. Christina Salmon finds Johnson. Back to Salmon. Duhaney trying to find Chantel Bailey, but he's intercepted. Now it breaks. Chantel Bailey is in. Chantel Bailey, the goalkeeper, and oh, she puts it just wide. Waterhouse missing another glorious opportunity yet again. They've had so many chances in this game. They've had so many chances in this game to put this one to bed, and they keep missing. And Olympic Gardens have made them pay. Will they make them pay again? There's another break in play here as another Olympic Gardens player has gone down inside the box and will receive treatment. So a bit of a breather for some of these Olympic Gardens players who have had to work overtime since the dismissal of Renee Scott in the first half, both picking up two yellow cards in the space of 5 minutes. All these Waterhouse, or these Olympic Gardens players rather, putting in double shifts to cover for that dismissed player and doing so very excellently, managing to pull level. So have to commend them on this brilliant effort. They've been very, very good in this final. So Olympic Gardens restarts play with a goal kick. Waterhouse players appealing for a handball. Play on, says the referee, but it does break to Waterhouse. It's intercepted by Olympic Gardens. White. Tashika Small goes to ground and makes the interception. Now it's with Jessica Johnson. Really intense match here. Locked at 1-1. Both teams going for the win. It's Waterhouse on the attack now, but Roxine Salmon will see that one out for a goal kick. Ball sent long. It's intercepted again by Waterhouse. Nice header that from Pollock. Sharon Beer went into the back of Pollock on that challenge, but the referee says nothing doing. Nice interception that from Pollock. Now it breaks for Monique Price. Price with Blair in close attendance. Plays it down the line for Pollock. Now Waterhouse needs to get back. Nice back heel that, but Lacey Ann Murray is covering. I think she seemed as if Lacey Ann Murray got her foot to that one, but the referee says it's out off of Monique Price, and it will be a goal kick. A goal kick is taken quickly. Tashika Small sends that one long. It does find Chantel Bailey, who shows a lovely bit of skill. Chantel Bailey with a lovely piece of skill just now to dink the ball over the head of number 18 for Olympic Gardens, Kishana Robinson. But Robinson didn't give up and was tracking back to make the challenge, and the arm of Chantel Bailey went up into the face. So it's a free kick to Waterhouse and a yellow card to Chantel Bailey. Chantel Bailey with a lovely bit of skill, but it was all undone in a few moments. So it's a free kick to Olympic Gardens now, following that yellow card to Chantel Bailey. And the ball over the top looking for Kevina Reed again. She's in here, and Tashika Small had to meet the challenge. Sends that one behind for a goal kick. It's a corner kick, rather. So another chance here for Olympic Gardens to get some players in the box and trouble Tiana Schrauter in goal. Olympic Gardens really in the ascendancy now after that goal. And it's Sawyers who goes across to take this corner kick. Kevina Reed has gone into the box. Corner swung in to the near post. It finds Kevina Reed with a flick on, and it goes in. Kevina Reed with a flick on at the near post, and it sneaks in at the far post. Olympic Gardens go in front. It's unbelievable. Olympic Gardens, playing with 10 players, have clawed their way back and gone in front to lead Waterhouse by 2-1 here in the final of the JFF Women's Knockout Competition. Brilliant stuff. Immense character shown by Olympic Gardens to go in front. Kevina Reed having a brilliant game.
Number 23, Kevina Reed with her second goal, putting Olympic Gardens in front in the 81st minute. Olympic Gardens 2, Waterhouse 1. 2019-2020 JFF Women's Knockout Final.
Can you believe it?
Waterhouse looking for tackle number 3.
Waterhouse aiming to complete the treble. Olympic Gardens aiming to win their first title. Olympic Gardens, the men's underdogs in this one, going down by a goal to nil and losing a player, and they have managed to claw their way back. This is absolutely amazing. And they're here, breaking away again. Tashika Small doing well to cover. Tiana Schrauter is far out of her goal, pushing the team up. It's all or nothing for Waterhouse now. Tiana Schrauter is far, very, very, very advanced into her own half. Way off her line. I don't know if the Olympic Gardens team has noticed us yet, but very dangerous from a goalkeeper. It's Kevina Reed again, trying to knock it around Williams. Kevina Reed not giving up this one. Tiana Schrauter has to come and make the clearance. Waterhouse at sixes and sevens now. I don't think I've ever seen them like this. Olympic Gardens really putting them under pressure, putting them to the sword here with 10 players. Unbelievable. Waterhouse have made a lot of substitutions. They have a lot of young players on the field. But this is amazing. Olympic Gardens playing with 10 players. If they can hold on to this scoreline, this will be a massive upset. Throwing taken. Price, and it's a swipe by Jessica Johnson. It's in to Kevina Reed now. Reed on the left foot. Does have the strike, but it's blocked by Dehaney. Waterhouse trying to break now. It's with Salmon. Salmon looking for the run off Lacey and Murray, but it's intercepted by Roxine Salmon. Dehaney battling with Monique Price. It breaks to Williams. Williams driving forward now. It needs to be closed down, and she is closed down by Kevina Reed. Makes the block, and it's out for a throw-in. Kevina Reed has stayed down following that challenge. The referee says, get on with the game. Strong challenge by Sawyers, and Kevina Reed comes back to win possession. The tackles are really flying in here. Getting very chippy, and the referee draws for his pocket again. It's a red card. Oh, wow. Waterhouse players really, really losing their composure here. And Lacey and Murray is ejected in the second half. Lacey and Murray with a very wild challenge on Kevina Reed. And she is shown a straight red card.
To number 12, Lacey and Murray of Waterhouse. So that
having played a player down for most of this match, it's now level in that regard. Waterhouse now playing with 10 players as well. So it's 10 versus 10, but Waterhouse are trailing by 2-1. This match with another twist. Very enthralling final here at the UAJFF Captain Horace Brell Center of Excellence. It's Kevina Reed. What will she do now? She's really caused the Waterhouse a lot of problems today. Here she goes with another run. Lacey and Monique Price rather opting not to play her in on that occasion. But you can see it every time Kevina Reed gets the ball. She's playing with a lot of confidence now. And with all right, she's been brilliant in this game. Kevina Reed really putting Waterhouse to the sword here. Immense performance. And it's a foul throw. You don't really see that very often, but that's a foul throw. And referee says throw into Waterhouse. Olympic Gardens really pressuring Waterhouse here. It's back to Morgan. Morgan tries to play it in, but it's intercepted. Now Waterhouse looking promising. That's a brilliant ball through. Tiny Seaton goes through on goal. It's Tiny Seaton with a chance. She squares it, but it's behind Salmon. just not happening for Waterhouse at the moment. Tashika Small, the interception. She's closed down. Another ball looking for the run of Tiny Seaton, and it breaks. Tiny Seaton. Oh, that's a howler from the goalkeeper. It's a howler from the goalkeeper to give away a goal. Can you believe it? This match just keeps throwing up twists and turns.
Number 18.
That one is a hard one to take for the Olympic Gardens team, who have been brilliant. The goalkeeper, Tashelle Welcome, has been brilliant as well, but she'll want to forget that one. I mean, it's not all over. It's 2-2. Hard one to take. Tiny Seaton getting the equalizer after a mistake from Welcome. Olympic Gardens will have to pick themselves up after this one. They were doing so well. Only to be undone by a mistake from the goalkeeper. Ball goes out over on the far side. Time running out here. Olympic Gardens couldn't hold on to the lead, but it's 2-2. Coach just encouraging the goalkeeper Welcome there to lift her head and carry on. She's been very good in this match. But a very crucial mistake has cost her team a goal. Both teams very much still in this match with a chance of lifting the title. The trophy on the line, time running out. Will this one go to extra time or will we have a winner? In normal time, it's Waterhouse who are in the ascendancy now, coming forward with Jessica Johnson. Jessica Johnson is closely watched by Sawyers Williams. Johnson, nice touch there from Johnson. Strong tackle. Match is very intense. Tackles flying in from both teams. I can't recall ever seeing a match played at this intensity throughout the season. Very enjoyable match, and the spectators are fully into it. Shot from way out from Duane. It's off target and it's low and weak, and that one won't trouble Welcome. Welcome making the save. Monique Price trying to play that one through, but it's intercepted by Williams. Breaks back to Monique Price, who bursts. She has the run of Pollock wide. That one doesn't have enough on it to get there. Pollock hustling, trying to make it difficult for the defense. Tiny Seaton making a run down this right-hand side, and she collects it. She has the run of Salmon. Tiny Seaton playing with a lot of confidence now after scoring that equalizer. Here's Kevina Reed squaring up against Williams. Kevina Reed trying to go on the outside. She does go past her. I think she's overdone that one. It has gone over the line. It will be a goal kick. Williams did well on that occasion to just shepherd Kevina Reed and make sure she didn't really have the option of cutting inside. Another long pass. And Tiny Seaton is off. Goalkeeper Welcome does come. That one will do a world of good for her confidence following that mistake earlier. Christina Salmon plays it out to Jessica Johnson. Tries to place it over the top, and that's a brilliant ball for Tiny Seaton. It's quickly closed down. Does break back to Seaton. Seaton going up against. Now it's Anderson. Can she get the cross in? She has Seaton in support, and it's blocked by Pollock. Still Pollock. Pollock with a strong challenge there on Anderson. The throw into Waterhouse. Time running out here. Waterhouse trying to get the winner. Clearance is blocked by her own teammate, and it will break back to Waterhouse. Waterhouse really pushing forward now, looking for that winning goal. Small swings it in, and it's cleared. Chantel Bailey in the back of Kevina Reed. Bailey very vocal on the pitch, really guiding the younger players, telling them to move into position and organizing her team. Really experienced player, has experience with the senior reggae girls and bringing that here to her Waterhouse teammates. Very good player to have. Hasn't really come to life in this final, but still time to go. Wouldn't write her off just yet. She might yet find the winner for her team as Waterhouse come forward with Christina Salmon. Now it's Chantel Bailey trying to find the run of Tiny Seaton, but it's intercepted. Nice move there from Tashika Small. The pass out to Jessica Johnson was intercepted. Both sets of Duhaniu lines up the shot from way out. It's wide and that one won't trouble the goalkeeper. And that's the final whistle from the referee. It's 1-1 at the end of regulation time.
So that's the end of normal time.
So we'll be going into extra time to decide the winner of the 2019-20 JFF knockout competition after Waterhouse went ahead with a penalty from Davia Richards, only for Kevin Ari to draw a level after Renee Scott was dismissed in the first half. Kevina Reed struck again in the second half to put her team in the lead before a mistake from Welcome in the Arnett in the Olympic Gardens goal saw Waterhouse draw level late in the match. It's 2-2. Still all to play for both teams here in the final. Okay, so we'll have extra time here to decide the winner. If not in extra time, then we'll go to penalty kicks. But instead of 15 minutes per half in extra time, we'll have 10 minutes both ways because we're losing light here. And we don't have floodlights here at the UJFF Captain Norris Burrell Center of Excellence. So the match commissioner making the decision to play it 10 minutes per half while we still have light. And will that be enough time to decide the winner here? It's currently locked at 2-2. And Waterhouse gets us on the way in this first half of the second. Waterhouse in possession, actually. It was Olympic Gardens who got us on the way in the first half of extra time in the JFF Women's Knockout Competition Final. Olympic Gardens in possession now. Both teams locked at 2-all after really playing their all out throughout 90 minutes. It's been a topsy-turvy final. Oh, and Monique Price is brought down there by Tashika Small as a free kick to Olympic Gardens. Kevina Reed, who is on a brace going across to take this one. Both teams will want to find the winner, but neither team will want to lose it at this point. Ball swung in. Clearance completed by Salmon. It's intercepted. Anderson breaking forward. Cuts it back and finds Dehaney. Dehaney spreads it across to Blair. Blair will spread it out wide to Williams. Jessica Johnson over on this near side. Waterhouse just slowing it down and knocking the ball around. This is what you're used to seeing from Waterhouse. Composed build-up play. They haven't really been their usual selves today. Nice move that to get past Pollock from Blair. Pollock really pressing the Waterhouse players. Salmon being crowded out there. That one goes out of play off the foot of Christophanie Lazarus, who has entered the match. Throw-in taken by Waterhouse. Not a very good throw-in as it doesn't find any of the Waterhouse players. It's intercepted by Williams. Find Chantel Bailey. Chantel Bailey quickly closed down by Pollock. Still Chantel Bailey. Nice feed from Chantel Bailey. Still Chantel Bailey going. She's tackled up and loses possession. The Olympic Gardens can break. Ooh, that's a late challenge by Tiny Seaton, and the card comes out immediately. Tiny Seaton goes into the referee's book for that challenge. That one breaks for Kevina Reed. Kevina Reed tackled up there and loses her possession. Goes down on the challenge, but referee says nothing doing. Get up and play continues. Waterhouse conceding possession over on that far side to give the throw into Olympic Gardens though. So Olympic Gardens can keep the pressure on in this attacking third. That one goes over the head of Monique Price, but there's no one in the box for her to cross it to. Olympic Gardens players not making any runs. They're just walking. Monique Price surrounded by four players, doing brilliantly to wiggle her way through. Still Monique Price. Monique Price trying to do it all on her own just now, but you can't blame her. She didn't really have much support in the box from her teammates. And eventually loses her possession. Now this breaks to Pollock. Pollock finds Kevina Reed. Reed with pace to burn. Can she get past Williams? Still Reed. Loses her footing, but gains back her balance. Still Kevina Reed. Nice work there from Williams, who still Reed. I don't know what happened there, but Kevina Reed is passed and she goes through and she over hits it. Brilliant work from Kevina Reed to get by the challenge, but in the end couldn't find the finishing touch. She left Williams in a heap. Goal kick taken by Waterhouse. Still locked at 2-all here. Still a chance of both teams to claim glory and win the title. Which team will step up? Write their name into the history books. It's Waterhouse coming forward now. Jessica Johnson goes through the legs of Sawyers. That one cut out. Now it breaks to Monique Price. Trying to find Kevina Reed, but it's intercepted. Tashika Small running into the back of Kevina Reed just there. Off the ball, but referee says nothing. Nothing doing, and they play on. I think that was a foul off the ball, but referee didn't see it. Nice turn there from Lazarus. And wins a free kick. Tashika Small is everywhere. Keep organizing her wall here, and it's Kevina Reed with another free kick. They'll be wary of her now after that first strike, which drew her team level. Kevina Reed with that familiar stance. Can she do it again? There's no way she's going to do it again. Can she? It's Kevina Reed over this one. The run up, the strike. She goes for the near post this time. She goes for the curler. First time she blasted it into the net. This time she goes for the curl and it goes just wide. It's a poor goal kick. It's easily won back by Olympic Gardens. Pollock pushing it past Small. Hurdled her. Referee calls for a free kick. The foul goes against Waterhouse. Waterhouse players are bemused. They thought that Pollock had fouled Williams on that occasion, but referee says no. It's a free kick to Olympic Gardens, rather, in a very dangerous position. This time it's Monique Price who comes across to take the free kick. The cutback on the top of the area right here is on. If Monique Price can see her teammate, she's left on mark. Monique Price with the left foot to whip it in. She goes to the far post. Too much on that one. And it's overhit. Runs all the way through for a goal kick. Bit of an anticlimax, that one. It was a very promising position. Olympic Gardens doesn't take advantage of that one, so it wants a house get away. Duane comes back to take the goal kick and goes over the head of Tiny Seaton. Possession back with Olympic Gardens now, trying to come forward. It's with Kevina Reed. Reed is tackled up by Salmon, but Reed showing great strength. And a player really known for her strength, more known for her pace, but she showed good strength on that occasion. Now Pollock is having a really good game as well. Really complimenting her attack on whichever flank she plays on. She and Kevina Reed interchanging on both flanks throughout the game and causing this Waterhouse defense all sorts of trouble. Here's Pollock again. Swings it in, but again, there's no one in the box. easily claimed by the goalkeeper, Schroeter. Referee blows for the end of the first half of extra time here, and he says switch. So there will be no break. The players will just switch right around. I will get started for that second half of extra time. Referee trying to move it right along as we're losing light here at the JFF Captain Horace Brothers Center of Excellence. We want to decide the winner before it gets too dark. As I said earlier, there are no floodlights here. So have to work with the lighting, the natural lighting. So the players have switched around quite quickly, and we'll get right on the way with the second half with Waterhouse kicking from left to right. It's Tiny Seaton looking for the 1-2 with Duhaney. Seaton won't get there. It's intercepted by Morgan. Now Pollock. One back by Monique Price. Free kick here for Olympic Gardens. Ball over the top. Searching for the run of Kevina Reed. It's a dangerous position. Shot by Sawyers is blocked by Jessica Johnson. That one was looking for Kevina Reed. Broke to Sawyers, who had the shot. Was blocked by Jessica Johnson, but a half chance there for Olympic Gardens. Results in a corner kick. Swung in by Sawyers. Keeper comes, breaks, and it's in. Referee calls for a foul against Olympic Gardens. They thought they had won it for a minute there. Referee called for a foul, and no Waterhouse can break. But Olympic Gardens tracking back very effectively to snuff out the counterattack. And referee blows for another foul. Waterhouse not happy with that one. Olympic Gardens referee getting a lot of stick from the Olympic Gardens fans and bench because all of these calls they are going against Olympic Gardens, and the fans and coaching staff are not in agreement with it. Some soft calls being made by the referee, but players really have to keep their composure. Nice attempt to win back possession there by Pollock, but Duhaney does well to stand their ground. Trying to play the 1-2 with Chantel Bailey. Back with Bailey now. Bailey looking for the run of Seaton. It's through to Seaton. Still trying to Seaton. The flag is up over on his far side. Players haven't seen it as yet, but now they do see it. Tiny Seaton being clattered by the goalkeeper. Stays down. Seems to be in a lot of pain. Seaton is back to her feet. Square of Waterhouse's second goal. Now play can resume. Less than 5 minutes to go here in the JFF Women's Knockout Competition Final between Waterhouse and Olympic Gardens. It's still locked at 2-2. And if we don't have a winner, it's going to penalty kicks. But that one played into space for Kevina Reed to chase, and she has pace to burn. She gets there, knocks it, tries to go around Tashika Small, but another brilliant challenge. She makes a crucial intervention. Kevina Reed was away. Does give up the corner kick though, but gives her team a chance to come back and organize themselves to defend this corner. Olympic Gardens with a chance to put this one into the box. Can they get the winner late in the second half of extra time here to prevent a penalty shootout? Sawyers is across to take the corner kick. Sawyers swings it in. Nice looking corner kick. The heads go up at the back post and it will be a free kick to Waterhouse. Brave defending from Anderson on that occasion to put her head in while the boots were going up. She wins her team the free kick and snuffs out the danger from a possible attack. Brilliant defending. Waterhouse with the free kick now. It's taken short by the goalkeeper and St. Long by Duhaney. Duhaney, another Waterhouse player who has been having a very good game. Chevin Blair. Brilliant burst forward. The pass was on for Jessica Johnson just now, but a brilliant interception by Sawyers. And now it does break to Kevina Reed. Kevina Reed will look to run. She hits it early. Looking to catch the goalkeeper out. Not sure if that was the best option. He goes wide and the chance is gone. Another quickly taken goal kick by Waterhouse. Waterhouse take the throw in very quickly. They're being pressured high up the field and it's brilliant work by Tiny Seaton to get past. Finds Chantel Bailey. Nice footwork. Plays the ball over the top looking for the run of Tiny Seaton. Morgan has to deal with this one. She does, but not cleared very effectively. And the cross is in. Danger. Well held by Welcome. Held. Well, it was spilled, but she held on to it the second time of asking. There was danger of a repeat just now. But she did well to hold on to it the second time of asking because Waterhouse were queuing up. Morgan has stayed down. Referee calls a halt to the play so she can get some attention. Resumes with Olympic Gardens and Monique Price breaks free. She's running through on goal. Tashika Small comes back. Kevina Reed in the box and Monique Price is taken down. The referee says nothing. He points for a goal kick. Waterhouse escape. I think Monique Price had a case there. She didn't really appeal, but Tashika Small with a clumsy challenge. Chantel Bailey taken down. And it's a free kick to Waterhouse. Waterhouse trying to take the free kick quickly. They have taken it quickly. Olympic Gardens waiting to make a substitution. But they have to defend here as Waterhouse come forward. It's cleared by Morgan. Still. Tiny Seaton here. Plays the 1-2 with Anderson, but she won't get there. Cleared by Morgan, and now the substitution can be made. It's number 13, Tashae Williams, who comes in for Olympic Gardens. Anderson here. trying to play the ball down the line for Monique Foster, for Monique Price rather, but it's well covered by Chevin Blair. Both teams would give anything for a goal right now. A goal right now would surely be the winner. Couldn't call a winner at this stage. It's honestly end-to-end stuff. It could go either way. Nice move there to get by Anderson from Williams, but again, it's Chevin Blair on the cover to complete the clearance. Goes over the head of Salmon, and Kevina Reed running Chevin Blair with a tackle. That looked to be a good tackle. Chevin Blair got her foot to the ball, but the referee calls for a foul. So Olympic Gardens with a free kick taken quickly. Kevina Reed thought about the shot, but she was quickly closed down. Now to Sawyers, plays in Kevina Reed. Brilliant covering from Jessica Johnson. Didn't allow Kevina Reed to get the shot off. Tiana Schroeter will go along, and that's the final whistle. So we go to penalty kicks. After 90 minutes of brilliant football and another intense 10 minutes both ways, 20 minutes of extra time, it's still locked at 2-all, and it goes to penalty kicks. So the champions of the 2019-20 JFF Lascelles Women's Knockout Competition will be decided by the relay of penalty kicks. I mean, at the beginning of the day, most people would have thought that Waterhouse would have been, you know, the runaway winners. They were huge favorites coming into this one, but Waterhouse haven't had it all their own way. Olympic Gardens have come here and they've really, really pushed Waterhouse all the way. They've really, really challenged them here today. Given a really good account of themselves, and they show that they are here on merit, a really good football team. And as I said, it's the lottery of the penalty kicks. Whatever happens here, both teams, especially Olympic Gardens, who played with just 10 players and equalized and went ahead for so long in the game, can be very proud of themselves. Up next, the dreaded penalty kicks. The kicks first on the way now. 20. It's Waterhouse who will take the first kick in this penalty shootout, and it's Latoya Duhaney going up against Tashelle Welcome. Duhaney, oh, misses. Not a good start for Waterhouse here in this penalty shootout. Duhaney hit that one with a lot of conviction, but not a lot of accuracy. Couldn't hold her composure.
Missing and for Waterhouse.
Waterhouse come immediately under pressure in the shootout. Can Olympic Gardens take advantage? Their first kick will be taken by their captain, Roxine Salmon. The huge frame of Tiana Schroeter in goal for Waterhouse sends up a prayer before this one will be taken by Roxine Salmon. Referee's whistle. Salmon runs up. Makes no mistake.
Captain Roxine,
it's advantage Olympic Gardens.
Olympic Gardens in front in the shootout. So Olympic Gardens won. Waterhouse nil.
Next up for Waterhouse will be Chevin Blair. Chevin Blair against Welcome for this one. Blair runs up. Dispatches it expertly into the corner to get Waterhouse off the mark in this penalty shootout.
But they have a kick in front, so number 16, Chevin Blair, scoring there. Stephanie Morgan. Up next, Olympic.
The captain, Morgan, trying to put Olympic Gardens up 2-1 in the shootout now. Therefore, he's just reminding Shorter that she needs to keep her foot on the line while the penalty is being taken. Morgan over this one. Brilliant penalty. Low, hard into the corner.
In front is the Olympic Gardens team. Courtesy
2-1 to Olympic Gardens.
Number 3, Stephanie Morgan. Up next is
Jessica Johnson steps forward for Waterhouse.
Jessica Johnson.
Waterhouse already missing one of their kicks. Jessica Johnson needs to keep her team in this one. Johnson. Brilliant. So low and hard into the corner.
Waterhouse level on goal.
That's what you want to see for a penalty kick. Just try and put it into the corner, make it hard for the goalkeeper. So it's 2-2 now in the penalty shootout. Waterhouse taking one more kick than Olympic Gardens. This is Olympic Gardens' third kick in the shootout. And it's number 25 for Olympic Gardens, Ashley Sawyers. And she does put her team 3-2 up. Olympic Gardens perfect from the penalty spot so far in the shootout. Tiana Shorten needs to get in a save for her team because Olympic Gardens look as if they will not be missing
Ashley
any of these.
Sawyers,
up steps.
Three goals to two.
Sawyers completing a brilliant game. You know, by converting her penalty. She's been brilliant since coming on in the first half. Now up steps Chantel Bailey, national striker and star striker for Waterhouse. Leading goal scorer in the competition. Waterhouse's talisman. Very confident player. Very charismatic as well. A real showman. Fancy run up from Chantel Bailey. Buries it. Very fancy Chantel penalty. Fancy and effective from Chantel Bailey.
Waterhouse level after four kicks from Waterhouse.
And a celebration to match.
Three. Waterhouse three. Waterhouse three from four. Olympic three from three.
So it's 3-3 in the penalty shootout. Waterhouse having taken one more penalty kick than Olympic Gardens. Kishana Robinson stepping forward for Olympic Gardens now to take their fourth penalty kick in this shootout.
Kishana Robinson. Up next for Olympic Garden.
Robinson. Oh, and it's a huge save from Tiana Shorter. I said it, she needed to come up big for her team, and she has. That's a huge save. Not the best penalty. She went to the right. It was right in the corner, but Tiana Shorter still had to put in a good dive and it's all square now. Both teams having taken four penalties. And it's 3-3. Final penalty.
For Waterhouse.
And it will be taken by the captain, Tashika Small. Waterhouse have the chance to go ahead in this penalty shootout for the first time. Tashika Small from the penalty spot. Can she lead her team to victory? And it's a brilliant save from Welcome. Redemption from Tashelle Welcome.
Final kick coming up for Olympic Garden.
Tashika Small went for power down the middle and a strong pair of hands from Welcome. Brilliant chance this for Olympic Gardens to claim the title. And it's their talisman, the star player, the woman of the match, stepping up to take the final penalty. If she scores this, Olympic Gardens wins the title. Score this, and Olympic Gardens wins their first title. It's Kevina Reed. Kevina Reed from the penalty spot to complete the victory for her team, and she does it! Kevina Reed scores the winning penalty for Olympic Gardens. Waterhouse defeated in the final. What a performance from this Olympic Gardens team. Brilliant performance, and they are the champions.
JFF Women's Knockout Competition.
Brilliant scenes. Ecstatic celebrations from the Olympic Gardens team. They really fought for this one. It's fully deserved. They played most of the match with 10 players. And you couldn't tell. This was a performance full of heart. They really wanted this one. This team has a brilliant fighting spirit and some brilliant players. Kevina Reed getting the winning penalty after scoring a brace in the match for her team. A lot of brilliant performances to culminate a brilliant campaign in this knockout competition that ends with silverware for Olympic Gardens. They win the derby match against their neighbors, Waterhouse, to win the 2020 JFF Women's Knockout Competition. Congratulations to Olympic Gardens.
Presentation coming up. Presentation coming up. Olympic Gardens still celebrating their first win. National competition. Presentation of the trophy to be made by chairperson for women's football. JFF, Miss Elaine Walker Brown. So, presentation. So, congratulations once again to Olympic Gardens.
winning their first national title, the JFF Women's Knockout Competition.
Did you get butcher a while ago? You get butcher a while ago? What was it? Bring a water for me.
Thank you. All right, so coach, I mean, first off, congrats on the victory here. A brilliant effort from your team. I mean, most of the match you're playing with 10 players. They equalized and took the lead, playing with 10 players. I mean, just describe the feeling.
I mean, it's self-explanatory still. It's sad going down 10, but you know, the players them dig deep and we came back and you know, I'm just happy for everybody. I'm just happy how the game went, so that's it.
I mean, you're happy with how the game went, but I mean, a lot of the cards went against your team. What would you have to say about some of the decisions that went against you?
I mean, yes, the referee needs improvement, but it's something that builds us as a team. So to come back from that, you know, it shows that we have guts as a team. So, you know, it builds us, and I hope my team learn from this.
Right. And I mean, describe the feeling winning the first title. Must be brilliant.
I mean, I can't even explain the feeling. It's good. Coming into this league as a young coach, I mean, you know, winning this title is really, it's a big thing for me. And it's a big thing for the team because we haven't won our title in the past. So it's the first title for the club. So, you know, Mr. Michael Pearty has been here with the team for years. So I'm just happy that we won today.
Kevin, a brilliant performance. I mean, last week in the semifinals, you were brilliant. Came back here today again and really put in a shift for your team. I mean, the odds are against you. Coming in, you're probably not favourites. And to get a red card and go down to 10 players in the first half. But you really dug in, showed character. I mean, you were out there leading from the front, getting two goals and scoring the winning penalty. I mean, what's going through your mind right now?
Well, I'm so excited. First of all, I just want to thank God and thank my teammates for getting this to this final. I know that I could have done it from I scored the free kick. I said, yes, this is my championship and I have to get this. So even my teammates said our job, I push to and I encourage each and every one and I still push to get the goals.
Okay. I mean, following your brilliant form recently, do you have aspirations of, you know, getting back into the senior team? Because you already have that experience. You've been there. Or is that something you're looking to get back into?
Well, yes, definitely. But then I wasn't ready. I wasn't that confident. But if I get the chance right now, I'm going to show the player that I am and I believe that I can do it.
A brilliant game of football here. Waterhouse, always dominant. But today, I mean, they were shocked. Tell me about your reaction to this game.
My first and foremost, I must congratulate the organizer and in particular Ian, you know, because he actually singled lead the troop, you know, for this for us to reach here. But it's so exciting. At the beginning, you're wondering who we really win, because knowing the game and say 30 minutes are about that and no goal scored, then you know that we're up for a good game. And seeing Olympic Garden come out as the winner, congratulations is in order. And also, football is well, because nobody can say now that Waterhouse will have to win and that, because they played. Waterhouse played, but Olympic Garden have the better of the day.
All right, brilliant. As I said, it's a really good advert for women's football. It shows that other teams are improving.
Yes, I agree with that, because when you looked at the league itself, I know when you look at the bottom six, yes, they're down there struggling, but at the top six, you know that football is live and well. And the two teams that really come to the final is really the two teams that play to reach a final. And congratulations again is in order.
It's wonderful. It was a real wonderful, entertaining game. Both teams wanted it. And I really happy for Olympic. They stood there for the last one of the players by red card, and it didn't make a difference in the game. And at the end of it, I think after all these years that they have been playing, finally they won a national championship. So I'm really happy for them. I'm really happy for women's football because of the quality and how the game ended. I really liked it.
Okay, great. As you said, a very good advert for women's football. I mean, Waterhouse dominating, yes. Olympic Garden's coming and challenging, so it shows that the football is growing.
Yes, and that's what we want to see. We want to show that other teams are improving and that one team is just taking it, and then it makes persons not interested, especially sponsors.
All right, thanks a lot. I mean, what's your reaction to this brilliant game of football?
Very refreshing. When you see what happened today, 2-2, then a penalty shootout. These girls are an example to perseverance. These Olympians, girl, I call them the Olympians because they are from Olympic Gardens. They did very well, exceptionally well. They're beaten finalists they did not make the finals in the league, but they are now the champions for the knockout. It argues well for the development of football, and it shows that the football is spreading. It's not one-sided as it used to be before. Teams are getting organized. They are getting the coaching right. They are getting the structure right, and this is what we are reaping, the different success from different teams.
Right, and I mean, it's a good advert for the women's football in Jamaica. As I said, it shows that other teams are developing, so it's not just what in times gone you would have backed Waterhouse to win. Yeah. Now it shows that other players in other teams are improving, and that is a good advert for the league, you know, and that would attract sponsors as well.
Absolutely, and what we are asking is using this opportunity to say to corporate Jamaica, hey, these young ladies have exhibited the skill, they are putting in the hard work, and they are reaping the success. Football is not, as I said, one-sided again. It is all the teams are getting their structure right, they are getting the organization correct, and we are seeing the results in different teams winning the competitions.
Alright, FIFA has deemed this the year of women's football. Now, how are you going to transfer what has happened today in terms of from the grassroots level all the way up to the national level?
Well, it's absolutely something that we want to happen in whatever we are doing. Grassroots football is where it all starts, and what we have seen today is encouraging that some of these girls started from our grassroots when we had our program started about 5 years ago. They are the ones that have excelled and matriculated into the different teams and performing well. Our grassroots program is something that has a little bit of dormancy now. We hope to get it up and running in very near future.
All right, thanks a lot.
Lascelles Employees and Partners Cooperative Credit Union is one of the leading medium-sized credit unions in Jamaica. We have over 50 years of serving our members with savings, loans, and insurance products. High-yielding investments such as the Golden Harvest, Compounder, and Partner Plus. We have life insurance for the entire family, back-to-school loans and grants, Easter loans, Christmas loans, share loans, motor vehicle, and mortgage loans. Become a member today. We are waiting for you. Contact us at 876-923-5480 or 876-619-6667. Follow us on Facebook at Lascelles Credit Union, on Instagram at LEPCCU, and you can visit our website at www.lascellescreditunion.com.